another episode of Match and Course Fishing Insights. Today we're at Lavender Hall again today. This time we're on Brook. So it's a pool I haven't fished for quite a long time actually, to be honest. It's not a particularly wide pool. It's averaging around 4 foot deep across the whole pool. There's a lot of pegs on it, 20 odd I believe, 25. The fishery's just done the pegs. They've made brand new platforms. Look really good actually, to be honest. Chicken wire on them so they don't, nobody slips. So that's all good. I was asked the other day, why am I fishing Lavender Hall so much? And why are all my videos on Lavender Hall? It's quite simple, to be honest. I was told a while ago now by a renowned match angler that I need to concentrate on one venue, learn as much as I can about that venue, and then that way, once you start getting into the money on the matches, it helps you progress to the bigger and better matches, more money, better wins. Plus, when you go into the bigger matches, you get yourself known. There's always a chance of that one day, or possibly a sponsorship. So, hey, there's no harm in trying, is there? Today, right, it's blazing sunshine at the present moment in time. It's now 9 o'clock in the morning. The temperature's at the moment around 10 degrees. Surprisingly enough, I had frost on the window this morning at 6, which may be a bit of an issue and it might knock the fish off for a few hours, but the temperature is supposed to rise to around 15-16 degrees today. The temperature is slowly rising throughout the week. Tomorrow I believe is 19-20 degrees, so the weather, summer is definitely getting there at the end. So tactics, what's the tactics for today? As I said earlier, it's not a particularly wide pool, so I ain't even going to bother with the method feeder. I'm not even going to bother with the bomb. Today it will be all out pole fishing, and looking at the pool at the present moment, there are a few fish that I can see on the top, so I might have a go at slapping a bit later, but predominantly it's going to be on the bottom. Expand up or hard pellet, probably top 2 plus 5, top 2 plus 4, depending on how the depth goes. If I can find a little hole, then I'll fish into it. It's got a very good head of carp, some cracking bream, skimmers, tench, good roach, good perch, rudd. So there's a mixture of everything in there. Predominantly today I think it's going to be the carp, to be quite honest. So I'm going to be feeding expanders as well as hard pellets, 4 mils, 6 mils, and I'll alternate on the hook a 4 mil and a 6 mil. Hook size probably 14, to be honest. 14 is more than enough for today. But there are some big chunks in there. So one thing I will mention, what I found on this venue at the moment, it may be just the time of the year, but it's what I found, that you can't leave your bait just dormant on the bottom. You can't do it. Every now and again, you need to lift, move your float, move your bait, to get them attracted to where you are. And usually, as soon as you move your bait, is when you get your bite. Don't leave it no more than 10, 15 seconds without any form of indication. Second line, I think it's going to be top 2 plus 2, top 2 plus 1. Again, dependent on the depth. I did notice over the past week or so that the fish have actually started coming in. So, hopefully, again, probably fishing pellets. But this time I'll probably chuck a couple of balls of ground bait down with it as well. And see, now and again on that line, if I don't get no indications within 5 minutes, go back to my previous line. bass in the last 2 hours. Nice 5 balls of ground bait into the edge if I've got a decent feature, and then half a cup of dead maggots. Then half an hour before I want to fish it, I'll cup in another ball and a few more maggots. If I see some tails or some movement or the water starting to colour up in that area, I may go on it a little bit earlier, but usually leave it till the last hour. It's amazing. Once the fish are in the edge, it's amazing the weight you can build just by fishing literally under your feet. Surprising. And matches have been won just off that. Like I said, I've set up a slapping rig as well. These fish in here are quite aggressive, and to be quite honest, I've noticed over the past few weeks I seem to be foul looking a lot of fish, and I haven't figured out exactly why. I've been fishing predominantly on the bottom. As the bait's going through the water, then I'm foul looking fish, which indicates to me that the fish are not on the bottom, that they're up in the water or mid water. So I have tried all the different depths to no avail, but as soon as I go back on the deck I get a fish. So I'm still working that one out. I don't know what exactly is going on with that, but I'll keep persevering with it. So I'm a little bit early, so what I'll probably do now is go and have a look at the pool. It looks quite nice from where I'm sitting at the moment, to be honest with you. The reeds are starting to grow. There's reeds all around on the far bank, even though they've been cut down, they're still reeds which protrude into the water. The pegs are actually out into the water a little bit, so you've got water underneath the peg, which may be an ideal area. People put in their keep nets in, it burrows away of that bed underneath the peg, or around the peg, which makes it a little bit deeper. That's an ideal spot. So
oh! des Himmels trägt geblam, laufen Brüder auf.